Hello everyone, welcome to Pondbird Plays The Binding of Isaac Afterbirth Plus. So this is my first sort of foray into recording any sort of games. As you can see, this is an old file. I've got 1001% from when Afterbirth was around. Still a couple achievements shy of the 1,000,000%. Mostly Keeper stuff, because Keeper sucks. Also got Azazel, Delirium, Greedier mode on Samson, and then things like the daily achievements, but just haven't gotten around to doing those. Might do them on camera, may do them on stream, not quite sure. But for now, just gonna play around a little bit. Just gonna play around. So, gonna do an Eden run for right now. And let's see what we got. Let's see. Here's a seed, MD8024GO, starting with Mom's Coin Purse, Anarchist Cookbook. Tier rate is good, damage is bad, but let's see if we can't mess that up a little bit.
Perks. Explosive.
And something's wrong. Okay, well that's not great, but see what we can't get happening over here. So, as this is my first video, let's go, take a little bit of time to introduce myself. Basically, been playing Isaac for, 500-ish hours so far. Ah, crap. Between, for Rebirth is when I first got into it. Didn't really play the Wrath of the Lamb or anything, not very much anyways, but don't want to do anything in that shop. But yeah, so Isaac's basically been something I've been into since I've saw, or since I've seen, crap, come on. Oh my goodness. Okay, well there goes all of our Spirit Heart and our extra sort of leeway for the next floor, but sometimes this is just how it's gonna be. Maybe this is the extra challenge of trying to talk while while playing this game. Common cold is okay. What was I saying? Basically got in this game watching Northern Lion play. Shout out to youtube.com/northernlion. I think is what his tag is. Maybe it's Northern Lion LP. That just might be his Twitter handle. Who knows? But let's see. Widow should be an easy fight. What? I have 404. Crap. Get rid of it. Okay. Well, there we go. Really should have noticed the trinket before now. Oh my goodness, this is just embarrassing. So this run probably won't make it up anywhere, but you know what? We're just doing a little test run for how recording is gonna go. So Widow's almost dead. Probably should use the Anarchist Cookbook here. Certainly could have gone any worse than that. HP is fine. Ugh. Don't love this, but let's get out of here. Hate burning basement. This isn't bad. At least we got a tinted rock and the wherewithal to crack into it. That would be nice. Give me a spirit heart. No. Okay. Totally fine. And now we've got a good chance to deal with the devil. So as far as I guess my playing style in Isaac, might be better, I guess, since we've already got progress towards Bookworm. Don't love it, but anyways, like I was saying, my playstyle tends to be a bit slower, a bit more methodical. I'm not usually Not usually trying to get to a boss rush or anything like that. Not a huge thing for me. Couple gulps. Retrovision. Well, gulp is good anyways. But yeah, so we're not looking awesome so far, but hopefully that'll... What is... You're not supposed to go those ways. What in the world? I thought... Okay. I don't think I've ever seen that pattern on that room before. They usually just start in the same direction, I thought. Oh, well. So... Well, that's disappointing. Should have just flushed it. But... That's... Okay, I guess. Might as well gulp the black lipstick. Because why not? I'm not 100% sure what that one does as far as evil. Maybe it makes black hearts more likely to show up. Doesn't look like it does anything for our double chance. But, you know, I guess we'll see what happens. Got about a 1 in 3 chance for a deal with the devil, as long as I don't royally screw it on Monstro here. Which is never... not a huge likelihood that I'm going to take damage here, but, you know, some of his shots can be a bit unpredictable at times. But looks like we're good. Growth hormones is awesome. We did get the deal with the devil chance and sin robes. Love that. So all of a sudden, we are actually in a very good spot on this run. Even though I probably don't deserve it, but, you know. Yeah, see, that's how that room is supposed to go. But, you know, I'm not bitter or anything. Don't really want to go to the shop. Don't really want to go to the curse room. But I guess I probably should. Seems like more often than not, those are just going to be, if not extremely helpful, usually they're not too bad. Walk into the fire. Yeah. No bombs. Well, then you know what that means. We're going to see what we can do with this anarchist cookbook play, which probably I'm actually going to roll with, just because... I don't know. Oh, get out of there. There we go. Alright, with that, I will go to the curse room. And it was a waste of time, but that's okay. I still don't really want to go to the shop, but you know what? I've got enough keys. Might as well, just in case it was the greed head with Lucky Penny's shop. Don't really want anything in there. So, let's get out of here. Okay. Why do you hate me? Oh well. Basement's done. Moving on to the flooded caves. It's not great. I hate Curse of the Lost. But it's not that bad, all things considered. Could be much worse. And this bony will die. Very good. Alright. That was kind of awesome. Made some dodges that probably shouldn't have worked, but they ended up working. Lust here would be great if we could get the virus. Yes! Already 2/3 of the way to Spun. That's awesome. Rakana is great. Ansus is great on A Curse of the Lost, but, you know, we'll just keep moving forward. Alright, so we've already got 3 out of 4 dead ends, which is great, so now we actually know roughly where we're going. Perfect. This room should be fine. Kill all the bats, kill all the exploding flies, looks like usually where a secret room is at. Ooh, and a sack of pennies. That'll be very nice. We haven't been too lucky on the money front. Haven't been too lucky because we're sitting at almost -1 luck, which is not where you want to be. pretty bad roll from an Eden start. Anything in the negatives is usually, I mean, I guess literally below average. I guess average would be zero. But you probably already knew that. If you stumbled upon this video, you're probably, I don't know, either a friend of mine in real life or an Isaac savant. Ooh, some pills. Okay, those are horrible. Let's maybe not take pills. I think we've only seen one that's been good, and that's the perks. Something's Wrong isn't bad, I guess, but it's not going to be terribly likely to make a difference in the grand scheme of things. Larry Jr. and Sr. have gone down. What do we have around? So let's see. Oh, sorry, Fat Bats. Not a great chance to deal with the devil on this floor. Ooh, we do get the prayer card, which definitely beats the crap out of Anarchist Cookbook. And self-sacrifice rune. Great. So I've already forgotten kind of where we're going here. And this is the big room, and there's a path downwards. Oh, this is the worst because of that right there. Ugh. It always just seems like that room is, unless you're kind of stacked already, seems like that's almost unavoidable damage, unless you react much better than I did. I definitely handled it poorly, and then that happens. Okay, so this is not super indicative of where I stand, I guess. It's more just embarrassing, but, you know, taking some really, really bad damage. You know, like I said, this is my first sort of try at recording myself playing Isaac. But, you know, maybe the seed will carry me and we'll end up having some fun. I mean, I'm having fun either way. Just because Isaac is always that sort of game where, you know, like I said, you're probably familiar if you're watching this right now, but, you know, it just seems to be that sort of game where you can go and you can make all these kind of mistakes, but, you know what, it doesn't really come back to bite you that often if you at least know what you're doing. Skill in dodging and shooting is one thing, probably half the equation, but another one is just knowing how the items work, how you can min-max your opportunities, how you can take advantage of everything that the game's gonna throw at you. Ooh, not like that. That should not have worked. So there's the shop. I can't remember if we've been to the item room. Oh yeah, the item room is prayer card. Do want to go to the shop. I've got enough money now. Okay, don't want a hookworm. Nickel is lovely. This is the ticket. So, right play here, don't pick up that key, don't pick up that key or that, picking up lucky pennies doesn't really matter because Humbling Bundle wouldn't make those doubled, but that is awesome. Let's race to deal with the double chance. Let's see, death, probably the sun is better, and I will take a spirit heart. Definitely don't want hookworm because that is not something that I enjoy. And let's keep moving on towards the boss. Should pop that. And who do we have? Gertie, not the champion, so it's gonna be an easy fight. Not as easy if it was the champion, but we'll make it work. It's just gonna take a long time. So damage 5.92 is good. Definitely better than where we started. I think it was around 3. But, you know, could always be better. And as far as what we're looking for in this deal with the devil, you know what? Let's not shoot for the moon. Let's say we could get Lord of the Pit. Yeah! Alright, so we actually got a deal with the devil, which is Not expected. Something's wrong. That's definitely not what you want. Let's, you know what? Take the magician just in case it's Krampus, and it is. So that'll help out just a little bit. Probably. And of course, we're probably looking for Lump of Coal here. I don't think I'll take Krampus's head. It's irrelevant because we didn't get it anyways. And now we've got the sun for the next floor. And let's get out of here. So far, so good. We're just on the regular caves. And of course, why would we expect to see our map at any point here? Lots of money. I forget if that guy gives you an extra devil chance. He does not. But we got our keys back. So no harm, no foul. Die, bonies. Freaking hate these guys. Consumables are getting out of control. And we are moving right along. I guess Common Cold is better than I probably gave it credit for. Poison damage isn't always, you know, the best thing to get. But it does do a couple extra ticks of damage. Makes things better. Okay. We've made it. Portals with the flies and the so-and-so and the blah blah blah. Irritating. But, wow, now we've got a lot of money. Yeah. Definitely all y'all should die. And that's gonna be an HP upgrade. So HP is looking real good. Means we can take advantage of basically any deal with the devil that we get should we be fortunate enough to beat the odds for another floor. These spiders suck. I mean, basically most enemies in the game suck if you have to actually take steps to, you know, play well, which is not something that I've been doing very well thus far on this run, but, you know, we'll make it work. This room's easy enough, just takes a little while usually. You gotta, at least the way I like to do it, is play it kind of slow, pick them off one at a time, sniper style. It's kind of at their mercy based on where they decide to pop up. If you're in a good spot for them, like that was not a good spot for this dude, but he's poisoned and there's just the one left. We're good. Okay, there's the shop. Definitely want that. Yeah, give me the 9-volt. Don't really want... Is that pay-to-play? Is that card judgment? Yeah, you know what? Give me something good to talk about. Something to talk about. That's not something good. It's another step towards mom and the addicted pill. All-time classic. But you know what? You do give us an extra deal with the double chance, so... Okay, I'm just gonna get the heck out of there. I need my item room. Sooner rather than later would be good. Wonder what this pill is. Oh, I don't know. Speed upgrade. It's actually really good. Get out of here, fat bats. Two fat bats. Fat black tomophies. See, but I don't have a tomo, so I can't really say that. Okay. It's a boss fight. So like I said, I tend to play Isaac relatively slowly, especially if you're used to watching someone like Northern Lion play. Boss rush is already out of the picture. Don't want to shoot all those poops just because that's boring. And quite frankly, we don't need to. There's a way up over here. Oh, great. We've already been there. Well, crap. I'm lost. Okay. Curse has done its job. Don't think we've been up here. Nope. This room's easy enough. Don't need to... Ooh, self-sacrifice room. Nothing super pressing going on in there.
Crap, where am I?
There's a new path. So there's secret rooms there to the left. Okay, that was really bad. But I think that's the first damage taken in a little bit, so that's not, you know, the worst thing in the world. Retrovision. Another great pill. That is not the secret room. That's surprising. It's okay. We will persevere. And what doesn't kill you makes you wish you were dead. And I guess I might as well pop that. I have no idea how many rooms are left. But at this point, 6 red hearts. I'm not really looking to min-max filling up all that much more, honestly. Another luck up is awesome. Here's the item room and a curse room. Probably go to it. Ooh, fat on mushroom. Yeah, so with all these red hearts, I don't really death card. Sun is just objectively better. Okay, so we're gonna break even. Plus 2 cents. And red patch. Which is not nothing. That was a death card. Pick those guys up and make our way back to the boss fight, which was over here? I think? Yeah. This is looking good. This way? Yeah. So it was the poops. There's lava, there's the boss fight. Rag Mega! Super glass cannon-y kind of boss. It's just hard to hit him. But he only takes a couple shots before he dies. Oh, I wish I had piercing shots. That would make this so much easier. But the poison. Okay, shout out to the common cold. And another deal with the devil. Yeah, definitely want to take both of these. No real reason not to. We got plenty of red hearts. Don't know why I checked the map. Can't see it anyways. Hopefully, 3 for 3, Curse of the Lost. Nope, Curse of the Blind. Yeah, definitely want to get rid of this room. It's annoying. And now we can see where we're going, see what we're working with on the floor. Stupid ghosts. You're done. And let's see. So there's. Let's see what we got going on here. We'll use that. We'll use this. Just because with Humbling Bundle, we should be expecting to get, you know, enough consumables that Guppy's Tail isn't going to be too much of a hindrance. If at all. Just need to get a. Couple random key drops from the overworld, or from the regular rooms, maybe a couple key drops from opening golden chests. We should be able to at least break even on most of those. Let's just keep on moving. Larry Jr.'s easy enough room, and the poison's gonna tear him up. Oh my goodness, well, we've got a fame. Secret room. Maybe try for black hearts or dry baby. No dry baby. Some more money, so we're definitely gonna get the shop up on this floor as well. Yeah, and the keys should not be an issue from Guppy's Tail. Hopefully. But, yeah, I guess we'll see. And there's always the ever-present chance to become Guppy, which you just, I mean, it's as close to a guaranteed win as you're gonna get, you know, apart from picking up Brimstone Mom's knife. Ooh, Deadeye's really good. Hit those guys. But that's okay, we don't need to kill him. I also want to hit up this mini boss, see what's going on over here. Pride. That's not really great, but an Ace of Diamonds. I think Magician's probably better, just because I don't really want to, or need to, turn everything into money. Yeah. Yeah, Deadeye's gonna be awesome. Oh, can't believe we didn't get hit there or anywhere. I am playing with fire. And did not get burned. Which doesn't usually happen. Usually I end up getting punished pretty heavily for those, but you know. Sometimes blind squirrel finds a nut every now and again too, right? I'm about as blind of a squirrel as you can get. That's not actually true, but you know. Either way, I hate these dudes that rush you down from off the screen. Maybe it wasn't off the screen, maybe I'm just being an idiot. Which is not out of the realm of possibility. Oh well. That was almost really bad. You know, maybe this recording thing is harder than I've given it credit for. Yes, I love this shop. Give me the luck. Give me restock. Give me a random donation. Black is so good. Ooh, Fate Reward is not great. Definitely want to keep Black Rune. Diplopia. Ooh, so how do we play this? Definitely do that. Force is steps one. Of course you get four spiders. Let's see, I could Diplopia and then Black Rune everything. A couple stat upgrades. It's not a bad idea. Get a couple extra consumables, whatever crappy pill that is. And I don't honestly need any more HP, so you know what? I think I'm gonna do that. Black Rune, yeah, give me all that. Some more luck, some tears. Some speed, which is now finally looking like I would want it to. It's a very comfortable level of speed. Once you approach two, it starts to get a little bit, maybe too much at times. Oh my goodness, I walked right into that. It's okay, we're gonna get little Gish here. Deal with the devil, deal with the devil. Okay. Can't win them all. Let's go down to the next floor where we're gonna fight Mom's Foot. Do have an arcade. I would love an IV bag. That'd be awesome. Don't really know. I was just about to say, I don't really know if I would want a blood bag. But why not? Let's stack it up. Got a pretty good chance with the deal with the devil, and I guess, you know, it's not necessarily. Oh my goodness. Not just for this floor, but for future floors as well. And you know what? Even if we don't get deals with the devil, it'll still give us room to play around with if I keep playing as awfully as I have been, so. Alright. Come at me. Kill the ooze. Kill the shooters, whatever the brimstone dudes are called. And already we're back up to 50 cents. So you see that Deadeye's really giving us a meaningful boost on these kinds of floors where you can focus a couple enemies down. I don't want that mimic. Bonzer Key is actually awesome right there. Deadeye with Lump of Coal, I think, stacks, so we're being able to get a lot of really good benefit from those. And 99 bombs. I mean, it's not terrible, I guess, but not really what you want, I guess, at this point in the game. Unlikely to get a whole lot of benefit out of using those. But, you know, who knows? Lucky Penny! And that's Mom. Probably should go to the shop first. And speaking of the devil, it's the devil. It's actually not, because I don't think I'm going to be going to Shoal on this run, just because, I don't know, rarely seems worth it, or as fun. And of course, Great Fight. But, you know, I might. I haven't decided yet. More money that I, unless we get money equals power, is gonna serve us absolutely with zero benefit. But that's okay. I'm not upset about it. Let's try for a second secret room. Yes! Ooh, interesting. So honestly, we might be able to make some pretty good things happen here. I don't want to go down too far. Just because, like I said, we, our red hearts are basically... Our capacity mapping is great. Even if we get a whole bunch of spirit hearts to drop. Okay, so now it's getting ridiculous. Alright, Mom. Get wrecked. Looks like Red Patch might be doing a little bit something for us, or maybe that's just the... Oh, crap! It's okay, we've got plenty of spirit hearts on the ground. Not gonna lose the deal with the Devil Chance, we got it! I'm gonna take a Polaroid. Say what you will, but it just seems more fun. Alrighty, and with that, we are down to the womb. So far looking so good. I mean, you know, about as good as you can get. What's the best way to go about this? Probably this way. Ooh, don't love this, but... Yeah, so portals are done. Portals are annoying. It seems like... I don't know if this is just a way things are coded from a... like if this carries over from Greedier Mode into the base game, but... Greedier Mode on the womb and the depths is just... I mean, things spawn so quickly. It's almost, like, impossible to keep up unless you're already stacked by that point. I don't know if the portals are coded necessarily the same way, but sometimes it seems like they might be. Where they can just, like, spit things out way faster than you could conceivably handle them, and then, of course, when things telefrag you like that, you do your best not to hit your computer. But we persevere. That's okay. Don't have a great deal with the Devil Chance here. Stacked up on HP. If you would kindly just, like, die. And Gurglings. Relatively easy room for the stage of the game. As long as you know their patterns. Alright. Oh yeah, where's the boss fight? Oh yeah, it's definitely that one down in the bottom left, but you gotta do a little around the world play to get there. Easy room. And, you know, maybe the portals aren't so bad. Maybe I was just overreacting a bit, which has been known to happen. More useless money. These dudes should be fine. Don't stand on the spikes like a dingle. Oh, there already was. No big deal, they're just gonna chase me down. Alright. Do I care about this dude? The keys? Yes. Since we do still have Guppy's tail, and you never know when all of a sudden you're gonna get, like, a million golden chests in a row. Of course. Oh, wow, when did we get 9 luck? Have I really just not paid attention for that long? I know we got that special shop twice, and... I guess a couple luck upgrades in between, so... Yeah, I guess maybe I just haven't paid attention. Oh, I blocked myself into a corner, this is awful. Get the... Yeah, just do that. Don't do that. Oh, luck upgrades, now we're at 10 luck. But yeah, so that was basically as poorly as you could hope to play that room, getting hit twice. Never really what you want. Ooh. Don't smack me, tentacle dude. Gotta think that's the second secret room. Oh my word. That's just not cool. Might as well take the Eternal Heart at this point. And we'll try our best not to get randomly telefragged by Daddy Longlegs, so... Never a guarantee, because this guy is kind of unfair at times. Other times he's very fair. And look at that, we've made it through! No deal with the devil, but a slight damage and another HP upgrade. So, we're going to go down with 11 red hearts to the mom's heart fight. That's kind of incredible. And the boss fight is definitely that curving one down around to the bottom left. Not a bad room, as far as big rooms go on the womb. Trade a key for two keys. I mean, you'd be losing money if you didn't. Maybe that's our secret room? Nope. And this is not a bad room, honestly, either. As long as you just play it carefully, play it low and slow, that's the tempo. Try and avoid all these spawners and annoying enemies. Go ahead and get this golden chest, just in case we get lucky. With a spirit heart! He's done it. The absolute madman. So that was, way too lucky. Very low percentage play, but it worked out, so now we've got a decent chance of a deal with the devil on this floor. Oh, if I'm not an idiot and squander it all there. You die, you die. Red chest with spiders. Just what the doctor ordered. And I could have skipped all of that, because that is our secret room. Oh well. No big deal, we're gonna raise our deal with the devil chance slightly, by 5%. Yeah, get some more useless cash. Not totally useless, I guess, if a judgment shows up. You know what? Die. Oh well, who cares about the money at this point? Okay, thank you, Little Gish, for slowing those guys down. You know, I don't think I've talked about Little Gish, but he's probably, honestly, one of my favorite familiars in the game. Having that extra slow can be very valuable, especially on rooms like that, where you kind of can lose track of what enemies are coming at you. Or at least I can lose track very easily of that sort of thing. Tinted rock. More keys, and a spirit heart can't do anything with. Something's wrong. Okay. Let's get Mom's Heart, hope for a deal with the devil. That's more likely than not, or as we say in the business, MLTN. See, that's a bit of a joke, because I work in accounting, I'm a CPA in public practice. That was so dumb, don't get hit again, though. God dang it! Oh, well, we don't need that. We're probably going to win. So, yeah, I work in public practice. And in order to basically take any position on a tax return, you've got to have a certain level of confidence that the position would be upheld if it was going to be reviewed by the IRS. And I know this is probably something that most of you want to hear, assuming anybody's actually going to watch this video. But, so more likely than not, as long as you're at a greater than 50% confidence, then, you know, you'd be able to take a position on a tax return without having to necessarily disclose it otherwise. So, yeah, I know I was stupid squandering the last deal with the devil chance that we're likely to get. Could always get a Joker card at any time, but I really don't want to have to rely on that. Isaac is definitely going to be up here. Stupid portals. Ooh, the quarter! Just in time. And the crow heart means nothing. Oh my goodness. I thought I got out of the way of that. Doesn't really matter. We've got enough HP that it's not super relevant. But then, you know, you almost go and get hit twice more! So don't do that, please. Another luck upgrade. It's going to be very nice once we get to the chest. See what kind of goodness we've got going on over there. Okay. Those rooms can be very tricky if you don't sort of get out in front of them like that. If you react slowly, they can sometimes be tricky to dodge those shots just because they're coming at strange intervals that you gotta time just right. Still not as bad as that one room on the, I think it only shows up on the caves where it's spikes that pop up every now and again, and then you've got the shooters coming at all from the left side. But that room's not even that bad if you can, like I said, if you can react quickly, or, I mean, since there's no combat, you can just walk out and walk back in and sort of level set there. Another golden chest. Would love, like, a cricket's head. Wouldn't be the worst thing in the world. Would not kick it out of bed for eating crackers. Which, honestly, like, I mean, so I'm a huge fan of watching Northern Lion's content, watch all of his Isaac videos, and that's an expression that he uses fairly regularly. And honestly, like, I think he kind of overuses it and maybe underestimates just how annoying having cracker crumbs in bed can be. Because, like, I mean, you think about it, I'm not one to eat in my bedroom. I don't personally see any reason for it because, you know, just, like, sit out on the couch. Sit out, you know, I've got a bar in my kitchen. You know, anywhere else, like, bed would be the last place that I would want to go to eat anything, basically. But, crap, should not have stood right there. Yeah, and then you, like, I mean, it's that same kind of feeling you get whenever you've been at the beach for a little while, right? And everything's just, like, sandy and gritty, and then if you're, like, trying to sleep in that? Ugh. I don't know. That would just drive me nuts. So, like, yeah. To say you're not going to kick something out of bed for eating crackers, that's, honestly pretty high praise. Definitely not going to go to the void floor here because that's just annoying, honestly. This room, or this run, isn't, super... Wow. What a haul. Yeah, so that's, like, just a really bad chest. Ares is useless for us, because we're already at 2 speed. Mom's eyeshadow, I guess, is okay. Pupula duplex is good, though. I love having wide tiers. Anything that sort of makes it easier to hit enemies on a regular, more consistent basis is fine. Ugh, crap. Yeah, it's okay. Scissors is just awful. Like, I mean, it's a reward for, what is it, dying 100 times or something? Pyromaniac! Well, we just won. Unkillable, literally, at this point. Such a good item. I guess I haven't been talking too much about what these items actually do. Pyromaniac, if you're not aware, it heals you for a heart every time you get hit by a bomb. Obviously, you don't no longer take damage to explosions, which is actually quite a few different enemy attacks. The super annoying champion Mega Fatty and it's either the cage or the gate, I think it's the cage, that attack where he jumps up and splits out a shockwave in 4 directions. Money equals power! Who called it? Who's good? Alright, so all that money wasn't necessarily useless. Although anything picked up after 99 cents effectively was, that's okay. Anemic is not bad, but it's a range upgrade for some reason. Anyways, like I was saying, the, another item? Butterbean, I think, is better than the scissors, because it can deflect bullets that are coming at you, which is going to be very useful in the Blue Baby fight. But yeah, a lot of things are coded in this game to be sort of explosions. Even if they're not, you wouldn't necessarily think they would be. Mom's foot is a good example. Whenever it comes down to stomp you, that's technically an explosion, so you can't get hit by Mom's foot anymore. Even though that's, like, you know, we're way past that. Yeah, Pyromaniac, just an incredible item. Rotten Baby, so good. Ooh, and another luck upgrade. So yeah, with 12 luck, we were able to get quite a few good items here on the chest. Yeah, get that Butterbean going! I love messing around with Butterbean on Blue Baby Fight. Because it makes for some weird patterns. Sort of makes it a bit interesting. Because otherwise, his patterns are, like, really easy. Probably easier than Isaac. Because Isaac, you have to like sit out in one spot or one side of the fight and kind of dodge him vertically. At least that's the way I found to be most effective. Blue Baby, you kind of have to strafe around him, but I find that to be a bit more natural. Maggie's Faith just in time. And boom goes dynamite. We have one. Alright, so that's the inaugural episode of the Binding of Isaac Afterbirth Plus. If you enjoyed the episode, please click the like button. You know, if you want to see more in the future, hit subscribe. Let me know in the comments below what else you'd like to see. Probably just going to do Eden runs for a little bit here, just because they give the most variants at the start, and I think that's fun. If you want to see me do random runs, I'm more than happy to do that. If you want to see me do a round robin sort of streak going through each character, let me know that. But anyways, that's it for now. Thanks if you've taken the time to watch this, and I will hopefully see you in the next one. Bye-bye.